How much of a difference does growing cover crops make on a farm? I'm Rob, and this is Snowflake from Dowdle Family Farms, and we're going to show you in this video the difference that we've seen in growing cover crops on the farm in terms of how it's improved the soil. Now, let me say from the very beginning, several people have asked me to show them digs into our soil, and I'm going to do that. The best way to tell a difference is really to have certain types of soil tests. I haven't gone through the hassle, and to be honest with you, do not plan on doing that anytime soon. I can see much more visibly the difference that growing cover crops has made on the soil for myself, and it's a huge difference. It's just hard to show that in video form, but I'm going to try to do that today. First, Snowflake and I are going to move to the first hole, which is about 200 feet that way, then another hole that's about 100 feet that way, and then finally we'll conclude with this hole and let you see what you think. This is kind of our standard pasture. Leaves do blow over here on it, but it grows summer grass as well. It grows cool season grass as well, and this gives you an idea of what our standard pastures without a whole lot of cover crops will look like. Now let's move to an area where we've been growing cover crops for a couple of years. Now this hole right here is in a paddock where we've had leaves and pigs and cover crops now for three growing seasons. It's less than 100 feet from that first soil dig that I showed you. It's hard to tell, but this is the top of the soil, so you've got deeper dark organic matter going down about 3 inches, maybe even 4 inches in some spots in this paddock. The reason I don't like showing this though as the standard just based on color is that when you grow sorghum sedan grass, it grows really, really, really deep roots, and those roots produce carbon and sugars for soil life. And so all of the benefit is not shown just in the top couple inches of the soil, but with a lot of crops, especially sorghum sedan grass, the benefits can be seen 2 or 3 feet down. So you may only add 2 inches of organic matter on top of the soil with leaves and cover crops here, but what you don't see is that a foot down, you may have a smaller percentage of organic matter than on the top, but you still have more carbon and organic matter that is spread out into the top 3 feet of soil rather than just the top 2, 3, 4, 5 inches. So I don't know if that makes sense or not, but just seeing the color and the horizons of the soil do not always do a whole lot of good. All right, Snowflake, let's go check out the other one. Now this hole is dug about 200 feet from the first hole and about 100 feet from the second hole that we just showed. This is where we started planting sorghum sedan grass the first time in several years. This is why I don't particularly like relying on just color and how deep it goes, because you can tell, yes, the darker soil goes down 3 1/4 inches or so. But where the biggest difference you can note, I don't think it's going to show up in the video very well, but the clay here, typically it's reddish or orangish. Now it is wet, but it's a little bit darker even deep down. So you don't have as deep of an immediate difference in soil, but deep down you notice a lot more difference. So I expanded the paddock that this is in right here by about 20 feet after the second year of growing sorghum sedan grass in the paddock right here where this hole is. And I'll pull the picture up and show you, but you can look at how after 5 or 6 weeks of drought, the stuff on the edges was dried up, but the stuff in the middle of the paddock where we had grown sorghum sedan grass the year before survived the droughty conditions about 3 weeks longer than the stuff on the edges where we had not grown sorghum sedan grass before. And I've noticed this on all areas of the farm where we've grown sorghum sedan grass and gotten good production in just one growing season. So I say all that to say soil profiles can be helpful, but really unless you get a soil test or unless you notice a whole lot by experience, just this picture does not do justice to how well cover crops improve soils. I hope this visual demonstration was a little helpful. I realize it's not as great as soil tests and all, and maybe one day we'll do that, I don't know. But have you noticed a difference in growing cover crops and how they've improved your soil? If so, let us know in the comments. What else have you done to help improve your soil on your farm or in your garden or your yard or on your homestead? If you found this video helpful, Snowflake would love it if you give it a thumbs up, shared it with other people, or just leave a comment saying, hey, I liked it, or hey, it wasn't all that helpful. Maybe try something else next time. It's Rob and Snowflake from Dowdle Family Farms signing off, hoping you have a wonderful day.